Thank you very much, and good day to all of you. Monsieur le Président de la Conférence Générale, Monsieur le Président du Comité Exécutif, Madame le Directeur Général, Excellences, Madame et Messieurs, it is an honor and a pleasure to lead Serbia's delegation at the 41st UNESCO General Conference. I would like to thank Director General Audrey Azoulay for your efforts in organizing this conference. And I have to say very honestly, we owe you a great deal of gratitude for the engagement, dedication, and leadership you have shown during these difficult times. Thank you. I would like to congratulate also President Murao on your election to this high office and thank your predecessor, Mr. Cengizer, for his dedicated and highly successful contribution over the past 2 years. As an organization with a 75-year-long history, UNESCO's role and activities are needed now more than ever. UNESCO's noble mission and unique expertise, supported by the willingness and determination of all member states to cooperate, are crucial tools to ensure the next generations can thrive. Republic of Serbia remains committed to making continued efforts to achieve visible and sustainable results in the implementation of the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development. We have attached special importance to the planning and implementation of activities aimed at achieving Goal 4, focused on ensuring equitable education and promoting lifelong learning opportunities for all. We have established the National Academy for Public Administration, where public servants can learn new skills. We have started introducing IT retraining and digital literacy courses so citizens, young and older alike, can learn programming and coding and be better equipped for the jobs of the future and connectivity. To reduce the gap in the labor market, we are opening a dozen of national training centers that will train the workforce for new and modern industrial jobs. And in order not to leave anyone behind, we have placed special focus on investments into rural broadband, with the goal to have almost 100% of our territory covered by high-speed internet by 2025. Serbia has been consistently committed to promoting science, and we are proud of the work of Water for Sustainable Development and Adaptation to Climate Change Center in Belgrade. We are also very much looking forward to the fact that Belgrade will host the World Conference on Basic Sciences and Sustainable Development in September next year. This is perhaps the largest scientific event supported by UNESCO, and we are eager to welcome you all to Serbia at that time. Furthermore, Serbia fully supports the adoption of the recommendation on open science, which identifies the shared values and principles of open science and concrete measures concerning open access and open data. We have established both an open data and an open science online portals in Serbia, and we are introducing the e-science concept. By the end of 2022, we will have a repository of all scientific production from Serbia with free access. I am particularly pleased that after 2 years of work, the global recommendation on ethics of artificial intelligence will be adopted. 2 years ago, the government of Serbia adopted the strategy for the development of artificial intelligence for the period 2020 to 2025 to enable utilization of artificial intelligence to promote and drive economic growth and employment and to create a better life for all citizens. Serbia strives to position itself as a leader in the development of AI through its implementation, and one of the key pillars is ethics. We have introduced AI into elementary and high schools and financed 7 new master courses in AI at different faculties across Serbia. The government also established the AI Institute of Serbia earlier this year to ensure that ethics are a core consideration as we develop and implement AI. In December, the Serbian Chamber of Commerce will be starting courses on AI and ethics in traditional industries. I am proud and I'm honored to lead a country that has become a regional leader in information technology and that is becoming a regional leader in artificial intelligence, all while respecting the guidelines and principles of AI ethics. Ladies and gentlemen, Serbia finds culture particularly important. Cultural heritage contributes to the identity of a nation, and special attention should be given to finding appropriate and efficient methods to protect it from all forms of violence and extremism. Unfortunately, I have to emphasize that the severe example of Serbia's cultural, historical, and spiritual heritage in Kosovo and Metohija is proof of how important the role of UNESCO is in protecting and preserving heritage. By inscribing them to the list of World Heritage in Danger, four gems of Serbian medieval cultural heritage in Kosovo and Metohija are being preserved: Dečani Monastery, Patriarchate of Peć, Gračanica, and Church of Our Lady of Ljeviška. However, hundreds of sites and monuments are still endangered. Serbian heritage in Kosovo and Metohija is of immeasurable importance, not only for the national identity of Serbia, but also as a part of the treasured European and world heritage. I would like to underline the consistent adherence of the Republic of Serbia to the core principles of UNESCO, grounded in the UN Charter and UNESCO Constitution, to dialogue and consensus rather than unilateralism. For this very reason, we continually advocate for depoliticizing UNESCO. It is the responsibility of all member states to preserve the principle of consensus and constructive and open dialogue on all issues under the UNESCO mandate. Sharing and recognizing UNESCO's global vision and leadership, Serbia stands as a reliable partner, strongly committed to the UNESCO mandate and its values. I thank you very much.